close enough to start?
It's only 4:30, boys. We've got an hour.
Early.
Let's call the meeting to order. Roll call, Steve. Vicki.
Here.
Myself, yes. Here. Mike.
Here.
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 Present. Consent agenda.
We have open meetings.
Oh, yeah. Over there is open meetings law. Consent agenda. Questions about the agenda? Any questions on the minutes? Mike said they take a little while to read through all those special meetings that we had in Iran.
This meeting seemed like ages ago.
I know, that's what I was thinking. Okay, financial reports.
Out of ordinary on the financial.
Okay. Claims.
They did take care of the tables.
I didn't think that's too bad.
I can't remember what charge per, maybe 8-12 or something.
Like what, $500 or something? $450. Reasonable.
$850.
$850.
For a small group like that.
Okay, there's no questions? Consider motion?
I'll make a motion to approve the agenda as stated.
One second.
Moved and seconded.
Some agendas laying up there on the.
Jason?
Yes.
Mike?
Yes.
Mike?
Yes.
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 Motion carries. Public comments. We are now at the portion of our agenda set aside for public comment. Each person wishing to address the board will be recognized by the board president. Also, each person wishing to address the board will be allowed only one opportunity to do so this evening. Request that you limit your comments to five minutes or less, and we will advise you when that 5 minute period has elapsed. Please remember that this is a public meeting for the conduct of the business of the Plainview Public School District. Offensive language, personal attacks, and hostile conduct will not be tolerated. You should be further advised that there's no legal protection for any comments that are filed in public comment.
I guess I just wanted to talk to you guys about junior kindergarten a little bit.
Okay.
And make sure that would be offered again next year.
Okay.
If I go through just my experience and the reasons why it's important to me.
Okay.
When Emma was in school, we didn't have JK, we didn't have preschool. And she went to Zion for 1 year. And then we actually went to Creighton with her because they had a great preschool, a great JK. And they actively sought to try to keep us there. I met with teachers, I met with the principal, but I am from Plainview, so I was going to come over here. So, and we had Miss Jensen as my kindergarten teacher, you know, I mean, awesome. You can't beat her. So we came over to Plainview to school, but I was, at that time, we did not have any of those programs. And I was blown away by that they had preschool and they had JK, and the principal was coming to try to get me to come there. And there's a lot of Brunswick kids going to Creighton right now because of different things. There's just opportunities, and I know that the Creighton school is actively going out and trying to get them. when Jackson went to preschool, I remember having a conference with Mrs. B, and they were supposed to cut a piece of paper. And she said, I cannot show you what Jackson cut because he refuses to hold a pair of scissors. And that was one of our last preschool meetings, and I had to make the decision, you know, fairly soon whether I was going to send him to preschool or whether we were going to participate in JK. He didn't say he hated school, but he didn't necessarily care to participate in everything. And I could not, there's a whole group of boys that are great friends, that great group of kids, but I could not think about sending him to a full day of school when he was struggling to get through a half day and didn't want to do what he had to do. This year, when we go to conferences, I think sending those boys, that whole group of boys, to junior kindergarten, when we go in and we talk to Mrs. Schrader right now at conferences, there's nothing but praise. And it's a whole, I mean, there's, I don't know what the numbers are, it's majority boys in that class. And she tells us that how these boys, she can get through her whole math lesson, and that rarely has happened in the past. This will be the first year she can get through the entire social studies book. She said they ask questions, and she goes, not waste time, try to get the teacher off subject, like insightful questions that they are listening and they want to do, they want to know more. And she's even said, some of the stuff they're going to have to wait until they get across the street so they can find out answers. But I'm sitting now with my daughter, who loves Mrs. B. I mean, if she sees her anywhere, she runs up, hugs her. I can't get her away from her. But every single morning, she tells me she does not want to go to school. She does not throw a fit. She doesn't throw a fit, but she tells me, I don't want to go. When I pick her up, she tells me it's awesome. But am I ready to send her to a full day of school if I don't feel that she's prepared for it? I feel like she needs another year of half day. I feel like she needs more preparation. I feel like she needs to have more time to grow up. She's young. She's not quite 5 yet. She won't be 5 until May. But I feel like she needs that extra time. I think kindergarten is such a huge step. There's so much expected of them. And I've kind of struggled with this decision because there's a great group of girls in her class that I would love to see her go on to school with, great group of families. But for her, I don't think she's ready. And I want her to be able to conquer it. I want her to feel that she is successful. And if we're talking about test scores and confidence, why would I not want her to go to JK? Why would I not want her to spend another year, half day, with Mrs. B, and then go on to kindergarten, where then she can be the best she can be, I guess. Give her that extra year to mature. So those were my thoughts. Sorry. Was that 5 minutes? I don't know. I don't know where you're at on that decision. I don't know how many kids you have, but I would love to see it offered. I think it's a program that we need to continue. And I think that we have it there. You can't have it, take it away, have it, take it away. And I think it's important to me. I think we have the best teachers offering this great, great curriculum to these.
Thank you. We aren't talking about that tonight, but I'm sure that's coming up soon.
Okay.
But one thing about that, mm-hmm. when you have junior kindergarten, I think, how many kids do we have in that last this year?
Four.
So that takes up a half a day of teacher's time, and then we were full in the second one. So sometimes it comes down to how many kids you can cover too, because we had to turn kids away from preschool. So sometimes when you look at those, this is just my. Sometimes when you look at those things, you got to look at how many kids you can help with, too. Because maybe the reason those kids were going to grade was because we were close to it. We were turning kids away. So that has to be taken into consideration, too. So.
Will we make that decision for JK before we have kindergarten preschool run up?
I don't make that decision.
So, the
71st.
Yeah.
name?
At least number wise, we're right.
Okay.
So I have an idea, but who will you send out letters?
Already been sent.
For JK, for Roundup?
Already been sent.
So the JK kids have been sent kindergarten letters, Roundup letters?
They got Roundup letters, preschool letters, and JK letters. Those were on the way.
One thing we, when we went through that interview process, you remember the guy from Arapahoe was talking about?
Oh, yeah, I had like a whole page of notes.
And that, I thought that was pretty nice that they were bringing in all those kids from surrounding areas. I don't know, he said that he was requiring them to go to that, stay in that school if they came into their preschool. I could do that.
I think though that.
They were serving a lot of kids.
And I think though that if you get them into a school, it was hard. When I took Emma over to Creighton, I did not originally have any intentions of keeping her there. But they were actively trying to get me to stay there. That's, I guess that's the whole reason I brought it up was just because they were trying to recruit and get me to go there. And so I thought of that guy from Arapahoe, yeah, I have all sorts of. What are we gonna do? Yeah, I'll be here next time. No, I'm just kidding.
We never did say whether those surrounding schools offered it or not though either. Maybe that was their only option.
It could have been, but he sounded like they had lots of kids and it was a good program, so. Talk about that next time. Anybody else?
Yeah, I was just, and I don't have kids any longer that are, you know, coming up into the program. I do have one that wasn't able to, Zachary is in first grade and he didn't get to go through junior kindergarten because that was the year that they, because of numbers or whatever, we didn't have it. Now he's adjusted extremely well now to that, you know, to between kindergarten and first grade, but he's the young, I don't know if he's exactly the youngest, but he's close. He's the smallest, not that we're in it for the red shirt or anything like that, but you know, for him, luckily he does well with the academics, so you know, he's been able to progress that way, but if I could have had that choice again, he would have been in JK, just because of, I think, you know, the benefit that it, for my son Reese, the benefit he got out of it was just amazing. He's part of that group with Jackson, and I don't know, when I compare that group, and you know, you're not supposed to compare your kids, but when I compare that group to Tanner's group, who he was in the preschool, but they didn't have junior kindergarten until the year after, or something like that. Anyway, they didn't have it at the time. And even him, I would have had go in that if it would have been eligible. I just think that extra year prepares them, you know, in this competitive, it's not the kindergarten of today is not the kindergarten when we went. And, you know, some of them are just not socially or emotionally ready, and I just think it's a huge benefit. I do know also that there's several, I have relatives, I have other friends who they're taking their kids over to the preschool at Osmond, not just Creighton, but Osmond as well. And, you know, they're even considering staying there. So it is a little bit of a concern, I think, that you know, you lose students just because they could start them out somewhere and then they end up staying there. So just some more food for thought.
Maybe we need to expand it all. Maybe we need to be able to have double preschool and a JK. I mean, is there any possibility? I mean, if you want to try to get kids into your school, you got to get them into that ground level. I mean, what's your options? What's your, you know?
Options are all open.
I don't know.
Okay, thank you. Any other ones? Okay. Discussion items. Discuss cooperative sponsorships with neighboring districts. Okay. Have we talked about when you guys went to Osmond?
Yeah.
You talked about
that last time.
Okay, and I asked Mr. Ault to talk to Superintendent Creighton, and you can tell us what you learned there. And I think she called you also, Patty.
I called Mrs. Peterson last week before I sent the board out, and at that time she
talked to Stephanie today. She said they would take our kids for football. Weren't really interested in much else. I said, well, our boys' numbers are low everywhere. And as we just had a discussion here, I find it hard to give them our kids.
So they must go in and be part of Creighton's team, but not...
My understanding is that they will play as Creighton Bulldogs.
Practice up there and play up there.
I'm not giving them my children.
Yeah.
So you'd rather have no program?
Well, Corey and I have talked about this over and over. Discuss it with Mr. Alt. If we have to play six man, then let's find some six man teams.
What are your numbers?
Because again, like Jackie said, those kids go up there. Now we're down to, well, there's only six people playing boys basketball. Maybe I want to go to school here. I mean, those are things we have to think about. This has pros and this is a double-edged sword, people. I'm just telling you. I don't know what the answer is. But I have a hard time just giving somebody our kids. Yes, I know we need the programs. But I don't know. And I think they're just strictly talking football alone. And basketball and wrestling are worse for boys than anything. There's seven, and one of those is a question mark for basketball. And there are four for wrestling.
So football, how many?
11.
This is junior high, right?
Uh-huh, 11.
Basketball six, and wrestling.
Well, basketball seven with one question mark.
Okay.
And wrestling is four with one question mark.
Is that question mark over as well as four and seven, or
including? That's including them. So I don't know. They're going to talk about it again tonight. I think.
Well, the thing is, we're not looking at this trend continuing all the way down. It's junior high, and then our numbers come back. It's not like we've got
two small classes all in a row. I thought, you know, when we started this process, we'd have some cooperation because we've done a lot of things with Creighton. I mean, we gave him a math teacher and saved him $63,000 a year. Thought maybe we could see a little of that, you know, and Osmond is the same way. They, from that meeting, they'll take our kids. So I don't know. This is a tough one.
That article that's in the paper that brought that guy said that somehow it was, we came to them about co-op and then we looked at it was in all our ballpark or in the paper anyway to see what's going to happen next.
And I am, who went to that meeting? I can't remember. Corey, you were about him. Did that, was that ever mentioned that we would get back to them?
Well, I think what they were talking about in the paper was if, because we asked them the same thing, if they would take our kids if we had no other option. And I think that was what they were talking about. That they were doing nothing unless we got back to them that we wanted our kids to go live for football. I think that's what that meant. Otherwise, they were, it was a no.
I don't think I'm going to do anything with anybody that didn't want to work with us. I mean, I agree with that.
What's the next? If we get, because we've got 11 for football, seven for best. If we get through that this year, do we have enough numbers coming up next year that we'll be fine?
We have for fifth grade. A lot?
Listen, a lot.
Yeah, I mean, you got a fair number of boys. Eligibility might be an issue.
How many are playing with you? Your son's fifth. football. How many are holding?
Two or three. Three plenty of kids are over there.
That's the only one.
Right, Liz?
Three, yeah.
Yeah.
But there will be next year, this fall, football.
Here.
So hopefully a lot more interest. Sorry, I don't know what I was talking. But there will be the youth football.
Playing
youth
program
now.
So you talked to the parents of these kids, and they were.
I have not. I was waiting to see what, after we got these numbers, and we're not really getting anywhere. We just keep hitting a stone wall.
But it would be nice to know if the parents, I mean, just because you have 11 kids say they're going out for football, are they really going to go out for football?
Exactly. Last year I had 15 and we had 11 that actually went out.
Do you know what kind of six man, what do you know any teams?
Santee.
Santee, there you go.
schools around.
But I mean, do we know how far are we talking?
I don't know.
Sam T will claim 3 dimes.
Kids are 3 dimes for that and.
And they'll have a different team every time.
So if you decide to do it, you're gonna have teams leaving at noon. I mean, we have, we're gonna have 6 a.m. You have no choice.
You drove to 4 hours.
But those people out there who don't.
So do you want me to send a letter? Do you want me to call these parents? This is really just pretty much a boys issue at this point. We can survive with girls with 11 and 11. And then, you know, the numerous girls that are out for cross country.
What do you got for girls? Volleyball?
11. Cracks me up.
Basketball, you got 11?
Yep.
And then you got a bunch of cross country.
Yeah.
Do you have any boys in cross country?
There's a couple. Mostly girls. There's a few, three.
Three girls or boy? How many girls?
Eight girls.
Three boys.
Well, I'd like to find out what the parents think. I'll ask them, if I can survey or call each one, if they're not that many. If they thought their kid would go out for which sports. And if the numbers that we're looking at, would they prefer us to struggle through the year or?
I think I would personally call them.
I think that'd be best.
Do you know that, from what she said about the pre-kindergarten, we can see proof when they go, I'm crazy.
Well, they will be. I mean, you would be crazy not to.
He may be gone.
Unless we just sit and wait and find out what they say. I mean, tomorrow I'm assuming she's gonna call you.
They're all saying, well, in a couple of years, we're gonna need some help.
I know. And in a couple of years, we'll be out of that.
We'll be out of it.
Slump.
So then are we supposed to take them in then? I don't understand the reasoning on this stuff.
I guess.
Well, I understand their side of it a little bit right now, because if they go with us, they're gonna bump up the class.
Not for junior high.
Not junior high, but for the high school sports. And if they bump up the class and they don't get any numbers doing that, what advantage is it to them right now?
Cause they're gonna be in the same boat if they don't do it.
Yeah, but they're looking at your kids right now, yeah.
I talked to Dean today and he said that when they were talking about the little kids wrestling program and he has 47 up there, and he said they have about 20, and so they're, I just went, and that, you're assuming that all those kids are gonna play or wrestle and not play basketball. You have some that do both, and
right.
End up making the decision after junior high what they wanna do.
So they're gonna be in the same boat, were you?
Yep.
I think unfortunately that's gonna boil down to, you look at the numbers, you know, we have enough kids, we have enough boys, we have enough girls. Program, it's just a matter of
participation.
Well, how you're going to participate.
And everybody's
that. And yeah, and that's what we struggle with in high school right now is, you know, the number of kids that have to participate in activities.
In all honesty, though, when I had these kids signed up, there are only two kids in the junior high that are not participating in any sport. And most of them are all at least two sports.
So that's not the same problem as we have in high school.
Right. So, I mean, they're out.
Where
the some of these
kids are
they're out for everything.
That could be the norm in junior high, too, and they drop out as they do that.
So in junior high, we have the kids that are participating. Like I said, there's only two that do no sports, period. And a lot of these are two and three.
Well, I think by next meeting, you should contact all the parents,
okay.
Survey them on all these questions, and we're going to talk about what Creighton says next month. And we'll have these answers.
They don't always read stuff that gets sent home.
Right.
So they can check them off the list and say, no, this is just boys, I assume, right?
Yes.
do it.
Are we done with this one? Let's go on and discuss the future plans for the junior high building. We can talk about the number of people that went on our tours. We can talk about that.
Last meeting, four conferences, I think.
How many do we have? Half a dozen?
Yeah, ten at the max.
We need one at once. When I was here.
I had one.
And I think I have two. So we didn't have very many, but I had quite a few people that talked to me in parent teacher conferences, you know, and said, what are you thinking about, and what are your plans, and I said, we're thinking about doing something about it, because stating my own opinion, I said, I thought usefulness is done, and it's decaying, and so we're trying to start the process. I think people have been talking about it that way, don't you? People have been asking me about it, people have been asking you guys about it. Not really?
Not really.
One was totally against it.
I don't know, somebody told me that we don't have taxes at all.
Is there anything else to tell you, ready to do something, or get off?
Yeah. We're gonna do something.
My opinion is right now, this year, next year, you know, a bond issue, why, I just don't think the people will go for it right now. With our numbers situation, we're talking about, our numbers dropping, why do we need to build, that's what you're saying.
I think until we get this, through this period of time, where we're talking about co-op, and we're talking about consolidation, or whatever we're talking about, until we get done with that. Again, get those questions settled, then we'll do something.
And I like the idea of the building fund, building that.
Oh, I do too.
Get to that point, pull back on it. It's not a large amount that we're taking out.
Right, and it's a good time to put that in. Okay, let's go to action items, approve the school calendar for 2016-17.
Yeah, I gave you a draft copy of the calendar last year, and then I did send it out to the staff, see if there's any input, I had one suggestion back, and that was on the days when we had 11:35 dismissals, to make 11:40 dismissals, so I changed that, so that's the bell time, we'll break, which we had.
Oh, okay.
Pretty big priority to it, yeah. And then the other change I made, in what I gave you before, I did not change a couple of my numbers, I try and tell the numbers each month, and for some reason, when I'm doing the calendar, I didn't update those, the total numbers for the year were fine. I mean, Jean was looking at it the other day, and she scared the death out of me, because it's not easy to find those days, but I hadn't changed days in a couple of months that really worked out.
Okay.
I panicked for a while, not about sending you back to square one, if you start balancing the days, but, so other than that, there, you know, there weren't any changes to what I presented last month.
Pretty short Christmas break. That's the way it is.
That's the way it is.
Last week they got almost two, last year they got almost two weeks.
That depends where the holidays set.
Yep, absolutely.
A little bit.
Yeah, it's early this year, but it was early as it could get next year.
Anybody have any other discussion on this?
I'll make a motion to approve the school calendar for the 2016-17 school year as presented.
Is there a second?
I'll second it.
Jason, second. Moving to seconded. Jason?
Yes.
Mike?
Yes.
Mike?
Yes.
Self, yes, Vicki?
Yes.
Steve?
Yes.
Motion carried. Discuss act on music lease payment.
Yeah, actually, Vicki brought this up to me, that when the board approved the lease, purchase on the music industry, they
discussions that went on. We didn't really have a copy of them. At least the way it would read, that the motion read, I think at that time, $11,000 a year. The actual lease was $11,920.27. So in order to get this thing going, the booster club did make up that $920.27 music booster did for the first year. But if the intent of the board was to make that payment every year, it'd probably be better, I think, cleaner to go back and make that vote, make that change now to pay, you know, make that entire payment. So I thought probably better bring it back and do that. That was the intent of the board. Otherwise, you're gonna have to make up $920 every year or something. You know, the booster club did not commit to that.
There were no missing.
Yeah.
Because they said 11,000.
And we did get the lease agreement finally, and we were able to, rather than music boosters paying for their part, and we did sell some old instruments to put the credit towards that to help out with this year.
So the instruments are all in and out now, everything's set?
One to go yet, I think.
We got one. When they're leaving school today, something come in today, but there might be one more. We did make a note on the lease, but at that time, it was not arrived.
The used stuff is all gone and settled on.
I know Mr. Jake is on site.
Yeah, what did he get for Zyla?
Zyla phone today, she thought. We couldn't tell for sure, but.
Free company called, said they were delivering a piano. They said they were more.
And they also said they're delivering a piano tomorrow. Well, we'll see what comes.
I'm sure they know what they're loading on the truck. At least I hope not.
Well, I'll make the motion to pay the entire annual lease payment of $11,920.27 to Mid Bell Music as they become due for the final 4 years of the lease agreement.
Just a second. Scott seconded. Moved and seconded. Myself, yes. Mike?
Yes.
Mike?
Yes.
Jason?
Yes.
Steve?
Yes.
Vicki?
Yes.
Motion carries. Okay. Discuss act on approving the purchase of technology equipment.
Okay. I think I gave you a copy. We talked about this last month, I believe. I had Mr. Sowers go through it kind of again. He made a couple of adjustments. But basically, this is the things that Mr. Sowers feels that, you know, we could purchase this and keep us in pretty good shape for the, you know, as far as technology purchase for next year. It includes some projectors. There's some laptop computers. We're moving some things around. There's some desktop computers go into the elementary and high school library here. Some updates memory wise, mostly I think that goes, well, some of that goes to the touchscreen TV in the hallway. New Mimeo, just some general things there. But, some laptop, Lebanese laptop, MacBook Airs, and some desktop models.
She said there's new memory for that TV. I know during the tournament that weekend, they were trying to watch Girls State and it kept cutting out. Is that fixed?
I would hope maybe the memory might help with that. I'm the wrong person to ask. Why I don't know if that maybe helps.
Is that the remote?
I think. I don't. I'm not going to say it. I don't tell us that's a piece of trouble. Whatever that means.
Well, from what he gave us last week, I had this one. That's what we got.
Yeah.
The last one. This is slightly.
Just a little bit less. And some of that's because.
$1,600 less.
He can reprice them. They're a little bit cheaper.
Okay. That's good. That's good. So that's like $2,600.
Yeah.
Less.
Yeah.
So the Apple book, the MacBook Airs, the 30 and the 15, 30 for high school, 50 for elementary, is that the carts or in teachers or?
Those would be classrooms? For students and the cart.
So is there 50 in a cart?
I think there's 30 in the cart.
We have 30 in the cart. But I think what he's going to do is move some from over here and put in the elementary.
Yes. some from over here, I think, go to the elementary, some of the new ones go in the elementary, they want to take some of them, put them in the ag, and I believe the, some of them are air parts, where we need to update some of them, those computers.
Okay.
Less protective environment for computers, they need to put new ones.
Yeah.
So there's a lot of dust.
So the 15 for the elementary will be on a card also.
Yeah, they'll be.
Yeah. And we did budget for, I think the budget's, let's say $75,000 for technology purposes.
Okay.
I'll make a motion to approve the technology purchases as presented.
Second, you second?
Second.
Okay. Move to second, second to approve the technology purchases. Vicki?
Yes.
Steve?
Yes.
Myself, yeah? Mike?
Yes.
Mike?
Yes.
Jason?
Yes.
Motion carries. Okay, number nine, discuss act on sanding, repainting the gym, pirate gym floor.
I should probably explain my comments in this a little bit. In the morning, when I send the boards to the town, it's great at 5:30 or quarter to six, and can't sleep. For some reason, it popped into my mind, never ask the board to approve doing the gym floor. You know, we talked about last year at the end of the fiscal year, we transfer that money into depreciation fund, you know, for the purpose of the lights and the floor. I just never thought of the board, so I thought, you know, maybe we better throw it on there. But I got to looking, and then we didn't have, the last bid I had on it was back in November 2014, which was a little bit out of date. But we did get a hold of Bob Flackey, who planned on having to do the floor. He sent up, he faxed us a new bid, or sent a new one, it is for the same amount he had before. So it's still the $17,940. Now that is for the, basically they will sand the floor down, and they'll take the lines and everything off. So this is one of the, you know, major sanding. You know, like each year, they just kind of run it up and then put new wax on it. This one will take the markings off and everything. And then they will paint new lines on it, and then they'll put, I don't know, one or two coats on it, everything you can do. Also on this, we need to understand that that's going to take care of the basic lining of the floor and that type of thing. And it's probably going to be a little bit more than that, depending on what we talk about or what we decide we want to do as far as, you know, we want to put Plainview Pirates, we want to put a pirate head on them, we want to put a pirate ship, whatever we want to do. One thing we are talking about doing is, drawings there. We're talking about this area in the 3-point circle, not making that a little bit darker, not real dark, but a little bit darker, set it off from the rest of the floor. If you watch like the state high school games on TV this year, if you were down in the arena down there, that's kind of what they had. And it just kind of offsets a little bit, I think it makes it really attractive to the floor. But we're going to put Plainview on one end and Pirates on the other. And then as far as, I haven't decided on a center thing. We might also look at doing, you know, maybe a small, you know, maybe a pirate head there or small ships there and vice versa in the middle or something. And those things are going to cost a little bit more. Not a whole lot. So the actual quote, remember, is just for the basic line. And that will also include, they will do some lines for our courts going.
And that would include the darker part in that?
Yes, yes.
Okay.
Do you know how expensive it is to start adding things like that?
No, I would say total, we might tie up another $1,000 for that, so I don't know.
So it's going to be less than $20,000.
I think so.
We don't need to put a dollar amount on that, do we, in the motion?
Well, I think if you do the motion here, and then, you know, we can bring that amount back, I think it'll be less than what I can approve.
Can we say less than, or for maximum?
It says plus the added cost.
Okay.
So we should be okay.
We should be okay.
Yeah.
We're not going to get too exotic on the extra things.
They usually don't put anything like a conference room or anything like that.
Yeah, I don't think we're going to change. I'd like to get
something like Oregon's got, have a forest. Maybe we can do a big cornfield.
Gives me a headache when I look at it. Do camouflage, and get camouflage uniforms, and they'll dry out.
I'll make a motion to approve Midwest Forest Specialist proposal, $17,490, for sanding and refinishing the prior gym floor, plus the added cost to paint letters, mascots, et cetera, as needed, as determined at a later date.
Is there a second?
You meant the amount on here, right, Vicky?
Yeah, $17,940.
$17,940. $940, yeah.
Second, please.
Second.
Jason?
Yes.
Mike?
Yes.
Mike?
Yes.
Self, yes, Vicky?
Yes.
Steve?
Yes.
Motion carried.
$17,940.
$940, yeah. Okay, discuss act on replacing gymnasium and weight room lights. That's for both gyms and the weight room, right?
Sent around some information on this. I decided it might be better to not put this in your board packet, if you're supposed to read it, because it's a little confusing and different things. We actually received bids from four different electricians and companies. And I asked them to give us a quote on the pirate gym, on the tarp gym, and then the weight room. I wanted to separate it out. So three different parts broken out. They end up appearing a little bit different. If you notice the first one, Peterson Electric, Jake broke his out with, you know, cost per fixture and labor and other materials, and then you get a total cost. It wasn't necessarily, well, like JP Electric, they just gave us a total quote for each one of them. But also, if you look at the one from Boss Lighting, it's Boss Lighting, that does not include labor. And so we would have to get an electrician to come in and paint those floors. They are, Boss Lighting is a company we buy a lot of our lights. You know, so we do deal quite a bit with them. That's how he got involved in this, you know, through other purchases and that type of thing. But this does not include the labor. And then on the patent electric, those are a little bit different. They are LED bulbs, but they're more of a, they look more like a fluorescent bulb. They're not quite as my understanding, quite as efficient as the other, the strip ones, and for the others. Theirs would be the, if looking at overall, would be the cheapest, probably bid, including labor. But I guess my recommendation is to go with the other type of LED fixtures because of the, I think, the efficiency of it, overall efficiency.
So you're looking at the lumens, column there. Is that per light or is that total for the whole set?
That is per light.
Now,
yeah, and actually, Gail and I spent a bit of time discussing that and trying to find information on it because my concern was we're in one of the bids you're looking at a fixture that provides half the lumens, half the light. So, what's going on there? And they did propose putting in two additional fixtures, but to me that didn't make up the difference in it either. So, tried to study it, gather as much information as we could. Peterson Electric did put together, had a gentleman was here, and he put together kind of a grid of what the foot candles would be across the court. And I kind of passed that around. You'll notice in the center of the court here, the foot candles run around between 61 to 72. When you get out to the outside, which would be where the bleachers are, or very ends of the court, put candles lighter for less. I got online, I tried Googling, I tried every place I could find to check the lumens and see what it would mean. Finally, I hated to do it, but I called one of the architectural firms that we talked to last year on the five school merger. I said, I don't know if you can
tell me, if you wanna tell me, but would you tell me, what do they recommend for foot candles in high school gymnasium? And, yeah, I'll put you in contact with their engineer, and he told me they recommend 50 foot candles, which 24,000 lumen ones will provide more than that. So plus, when we redo that floor, it's gonna be a lot lighter in there than what it is, you know, right now. Because that floor, the way it is right now, absorbs a lot of light.
But that floor will get back to that again.
It's gonna get back, yeah.
Twelve, 15 years, yes, it will.
Well, could we have a problem where it's too bright? I mean, looking at that light that Peterson put up there that night, it almost blinded me to look into it. What were the other ones gonna look like?
That was the other thing we thought about. You double the lumens, you double the brightness, you look up at that, are you gonna be blind? Are we gonna have to check out sunglasses for everyone?
When you walked in there, it was dark in the gym, and you looked out. If you have that light on, your eyes are gonna adjust to it, it's gonna, you know, bring it out. It's not gonna look that bright. And if it was volleyball and it was that bright, it'd be a little hard to pick it up. There were those shadows in it.
I called the superintendent of Windside, and they put these lights in, I wanna say it's 3 years ago. And I asked him, I said, have you guys had any problems with players, coaches say anything about the lights? And he said, nobody had ever said anything to him about being too bright.
That's the one that Peterson had here.
I think they were around that 24,000 lumens, but
were they answering the question?
It was actually put in by the second company there.
Oh, really?
But I don't think they would have that same thing. But he says they have not had any trouble.
Now I wonder, I mean, why do they have so much lumens for the pirate gym, but certainly not for the tartan? I mean, that's half again.
Well, I think on
that's
that
bigger.
Because of the, first of all, probably the use a little bit. You're in a smaller area. I think that ceiling is probably a little closer to the floor. Not a lot, but a little bit, which would make some difference.
Because I remember saying that night when we were over there, like tartan would be different because it's your secondary gym. And I didn't know what that meant, but you said your primary gym lighting is different than your secondary gym.
Yeah. And the tartan, is that figure on the new lights above the bleachers? Or
no,
just
that's,
above
just,
the
that's just over the playing floor. We didn't talk about replacing those.
So if those are the same lights, of course, I guess the lumens are $100 per fixture difference is the lumens, I suppose, and the bulbs, brightness of the bulb. But yet they're the same lights. Must be different bulbs.
They would be, basically you're gonna have double the deals in the bulbs. I think those
lights,
are probably, there's a,
$6 times 20.
wanted in, we want the lights, at least in the pirate gym, hung before the 20th of June, because that's when they're gonna start working on the gym floor. We want it done before the 20th of June.
And no one had any problems with that?
And I told him, you know, the others could be done later, but I also said, you know, whoever awarded it to, doesn't mean you have to wait until school's out. We can go into the pirate gym while school's still going on, and they can start working on it, because as long as the weather's nice, we're not gonna have people in there for PE classes, which, you know, we got the tarp gym we can use besides that, kids will be outside for recess. They should be able to get it done.
Peterson's doing it, he didn't want to do it on the weekends.
Weekends and nights.
Well, the Voss lighting will pay back 2.4 years, but like you said, there's no labor in that, figured in that either, I'm sure, otherwise that's, you know, looks like the best deal that way, but what's the labor anyway?
And who you get?
Well, Jake.
Jake's probably gonna do it.
From your town.
Just to see the payment, okay.
I would say the second, third one probably would be very comparable as far as your cost and your payback if you had to do it further.
What do we budget for this, do you know?
Well, we included this in the gym floors as far as money we put into the depreciation fund, and I don't remember what, we transferred $100,000. So it's, whatever, I know whatever to put in, there's enough to cover both of those.
The payback is quite a bit more on the tartan gym, if that's because you don't use them as much.
Probably not going to use them as much, yeah. The other thing we talked about with this, one of the things that will help with the efficiency is these lights can be turned on and off. You walk out of the gym, you can turn them off. You walk into the gym, you can turn them on. You don't have to wait 20 minutes for it to go back on or something.
Are they all bid in bags too?
What we wanted to look into doing is setting up so we'll have basically four circuits. One will cover like one half court playing area. The other one will be the other half. That one will be, you know, one row of bleachers, and one now get a little bleachers. So say somebody comes in and they want to just use one of the basket areas, they can use that switch. You don't have to turn the others on. The way it is now, it's one switch, they're all on. They're basically on almost all day long.
Still have a problem with Peterson Electric 2400 lumens per fixture, and it has 26, 4,000 on these other fixtures. So it looks to me like he's going to have twice as much light.
Well,
just, and I know that as you go down, you lose it and all those things.
The one, JP Electric, he did not, I think he talked about it when he was up here, but I don't remember. He was talking, putting candles. The Voss lighting one for the pirate gym, he says this will give you 89 foot candles on the average.
Okay, and this one, that's a lot more.
That's a lot more than what's on there.
But you said the engineer said we only need 51.
He told me 50.
So this is part of that, this is the 20.
You know, as a real life, when you get in the gym, you like to have a lot of light, and you hate having a shadow in a basketball game.
Is this floor on this one? It's pretty low.
This is like the baskets.
Yeah, it's a little up there. This is right against the wall, or is that right above the basket?
Probably out against the wall, I think.
lumen equals so many candles, correct?
Well,
an energy that it gives off.
The foot candle's gonna change the further you get away from it.
This is the foot candles at the floor, so it has to come off the light.
The light that it gives off decreases, and as you double the distance, it's 1/4. You know, it's an inverse square thing.
Sure.
You know, I'm talking about gravity works. If you go twice as far away, it's 1/4 the light.
I guess I'd take some stock into what the engineer said, because he's got nothing at stake. He says that's enough, and they build buildings, build gyms.
So which one are you guys thinking about? I mean, I don't, boss lady, I wish you would give us a labor.
Yeah, it's kind of tough to get there without the labor.
And who do you get to do it besides? How much would they be?
Well, Peterson here has $2,000 for the first one, $1,080 for the second, $380 for the third, so you're talking about $3,800 there. If you add that on to this, then you're at what, $24,000 for boss lighting? Is that right?
Yes.
You may not get electricity for that.
You may not.
Yeah. Because these guys have all made some stuff on their product too.
Right. Because none of the rest of them put it down.
No.
You're also getting a better fixture, a brighter fixture. Your payback is better. Payback is faster.
You're talking on boss.
On boss, yeah. And that's what I'm looking at, is the payback. Doesn't make any difference if you spend twice as much if you get back twice as fast.
Well, I mean,
you gotta get
why not?
That's cheaper.
Why not go with the boss and honestly see if Jake can do it for his labor? Jake's labor.
I don't think he'll do it for his neighbor. He's making so much a fixture, so that catch you a deal. He's
that makes
making
a difference on what he wants to do.
Oh, well, I figure, okay. I would guess.
Yeah, how about Stoffel?
He's leaving.
He's leaving.
Well, do you leave us? Is he gone that soon?
Yeah.
You don't be gone before school's out.
He's already gone.
Oh, yeah, already gone.
See, I thought he was actually going to put
he's already down working on it, Joe. JP Electric looks a little expensive to me.
You know, even if we figured Jake's labor on bosses, they're within $2,000 difference of each other, and Jake's right here in town if we have a problem.
Right.
Sometimes that's worth something.
Absolutely, that's worth something.
I'm not crazy about the one where we have to go buy our own bulbs and that.
I said I'm not in favor of those because they're not the same type of LED. They're an LED, but they're a different type. There's probably nothing wrong with it. If you've been at Randolph's gym, they basically have it there. I mean, they get good lighting. That's what they put morals to.
Now there's some kickback on this. Is that figured in?
I think
the town was going to do all that work.
I don't.
Kickback.
I think if you go through the electric company, I think there's an opportunity to get some kickback, yes.
But it would be the same.
Sounds illegal. That goes off.
Yeah. It would be the same no matter which one you go with, I assume. But I was wondering if that was figured into any of these figures.
Maybe that's in the payback.
Is this the disco graph?
Does it cut you like a
no, it's kind of like a payment. I don't think it comes up here like a great example. I have no idea. He was going to do all that paperwork and to get that. Maybe that's why it's cheaper.
But you didn't like the type of LEDs he had.
No.
think if you throw out JP Electric and Patton.
JP Electric one is where it was. I'm looking at the, this is the pirate gym. It said the project could be done for $28,170. There's a rebate of $1,800 available, not to exceed $2,500 per year. Total app rebate is $26,370. I think I used the $26,370. I don't know, didn't I?
On who, Peterson?
On the JP.
Oh, no, just the one. $26,370.
Yeah, I used that.
So that's already taken out of there.
So is that just with that company or bring that from any company?
I think you should be able to get it through the electric company. Although one of the electricians was hesitant when we told him that we got the electricity through the city. Come through there, but he wasn't sure if he would qualify.
So nobody would qualify.
If that's the case, nobody would qualify.
You don't think Mike would want, have any interest in installing it? He didn't want to bid on the fixtures.
He's too busy.
I just like to pay back for the 2.4 years, and that's the half.
Who are you getting, that would be my issue, because everybody is so busy.
But the thing, if that's, keep in mind there, my hesitation would be in that is labor included, not included in the pay. So you throw labor in, then that doesn't look quite.
Yeah, but you're getting twice the light, too.
Yeah.
And you could run into a problem, something's not working right. Is it the fixture or is it the installer's problem?
Sure, yeah, been there.
Well, with being local, we go with Jay, and we find out if that's on the body, I mean, at least it's in town.
Well, that's where that.
Well, he was guaranteed us that we would have that much light that he told us.
Light panels.
Should be adequate.
It's not adequate.
Then the research that they did is wrong, and they'd have to fix it.
They said it to an engineer, but.
That's right. I'm guessing you're not gonna know the difference unless you see one versus.
Right.
That's what we're talking about.
As long as it's adequate, they're gonna have to guarantee the work that it's adequate.
So we want to do all three at once?
Yeah, let's do them all.
I'll make a motion to approve the bid of Peterson and Electric to replace the lights in both gymnasiums and weight room with a cost of $26,698 to include material and labor. I second it.
Motion's been seconded to have Peterson replace the light fixtures.
Do we want the date that it has to be done by for that pirate gym?
If you want to put it in there, you can. And we talked to him about, I mean, that was part of it, we wanted it done, but it was misunderstood.
But I, June.
Needs to be done by June 20th, I think.
Okay, put that in.
Just the pirate gym to be done by June 20th?
Pirate gym has to be done by June 20th. And the other one, that's before school starts. Before the basketball starts. Okay, so the amended motion is that it has to be done by June 20th, and that the rest of the work has to be done before volleyball.
Before classes begin. Well, yeah, volleyball will start before that one.
Yeah, I start by the middle of August.
I'll say August 1.
Okay.
There was no wiring situation then in the weight room or the pirate gym? Fixtures that are there, they'll support the new fixtures.
Yeah, they'll put up new.
That wasn't there, how did you do it?
But it just didn't end in the right place.
Right.
Though, I think like the target gym, they're basically looking at putting the same place they are. It wasn't gonna move them around.
Okay, we ready to vote on this?
Yeah.
Jason?
Yes.
Mike?
Yes.
Mike?
Yes.
Myself, yes, Vicky?
Yes.
Steve?
Yes.
Motion carries. This one?
We want you out there measuring all those, I'm gonna get high on all your spots.
You'd get a light view of it, too, if I wanted to. Okay, we're down to number 11, background certified staff resignation.
Okay, Mr. Anderson did visit with me, as he indicated in board practice, why he's accepted a position, an opportunity to take my initial business over in Shelton, Iowa. So he will be leaving us. We have started advertising, I put it on Teach Nebraska, and it was in the World Herald today.
Good.
Is that a hard one to find?
Get them here.
There's 21 jobs open and 8 people from Nebraska graduated. On the paper.
Can we make him stay?
Don't think so.
Let me know.
I try.
That person in the interview ASAP.
We have discussed that.
Perfect. I'll make a motion to approve Heath Anderson's resignation as a science teacher, effective at the end of the current school year.
I'll second.
Second. Steve?
Yes.
Vicky?
Yes.
Myself, yes.
Mike?
Yes.
Mike?
Yes.
Yes.
We have something with regrets in there.
That?
Yeah.
Okay.
Since I think he's been a really good teacher, but really not a coach. And coach. Okay, number 12, approve hiring Darren Hall as superintendent of schools for the 2016-17 and 2017-18 school year. By the way, you need to start signing our packets.
Mailed it today.
And I'll give that information.
I just sent exactly what I mailed to you.
He's probably gonna wanna plug in your phone stuff, so.
You can try.
No, we can't. He will bug you.
Sort of then came back all right on the.
Yes.
And the contract is there to be signed.
Okay.
Yep.
Pre-signed it and put all the stuff that we talked about, the amount and the 50% on the. And the lieu of, and then the vacation days do not accumulate. What else we put in that's different?
Phone is the same.
Phone is 500. You give that every month, I think, right?
Yes, I write that out.
Could you like $500 by phone? I know there's something about, if we can renegotiate every year.
Right.
I'll make the motion to approve hiring Darren Hall as superintendent of schools for 2016-17 and 2017-18 school years at a salary and benefits for the initial year as agreed upon and published on the district website.
Second. Move to second. Jason?
Yes.
Mike?
Yes.
Mike?
Yes.
Myself, yes.
Yes.
Steve?
Yes.
Motion carries. Activity director's report.
Very much what I wrote down, what there is.
Come on. So we down to just the Plainview invite? Is there very, no, there's still quite a few.
Junior high is heavy this year, so.
There's just basically the Plainview invite and two other high school meets, that's all that's here.
Yeah.
And then I think the quad on junior high is here. And then the junior high invite is here.
Junior high.
Two?
Junior high are all here other than about two or three.
Yeah,
this year.
Most of the junior high are here.
Well, Neil and Pearson might go to those.
Right.
Eight of them there in Plainview this year, between high school and junior high.
Right.
Neely this year. Take out Osmond and Neely, we don't hardly have any. So we don't have any duels or transfers here in this game.
There's a triangular.
Only 29.
That first dollar's here.
Oh, I thought that was Osmond. I thought that was Osmond, but that's just Osmond Wausau, okay. Doesn't Osmond have their invite here anymore?
They don't have one.
They don't have one at all.
And Neely will be here, but after this year, they'll probably be there, because I think they're from their track, another track.
Six minor.
What?
Six minor.
Sports conference this year.
Okay, any questions for him? Okay, next we have principal's report.
Thank you.
What's wrong?
No, I'm just getting started. Actually, it's all right here. MAPS testing is supposed to be done tomorrow. We did not test any kids today. We have a few makeups from last week, but decided with the time change, I probably wasn't the most practical thing to do to those poor children today, or anybody else, because it's tough. I will tell you that when I was looking at scores, we have some fantastic teachers on our staff, and they need to be commended for that. We had a student score of 283 in math, and we make our kids be two grade levels above the national average, because if we are not two grade levels above, and I told you this before, only 50% of our people pass the state test, and at two grade levels above, we're at about 85%. I would guess that sixth graders are extremely high in math. I commended Mrs. Cush for her hard work, because they did extremely well compared to what they had been doing. Like I said, one of our sophomores had a 283, there was a 279, and I would bet half of that group was in the 260s, and they only needed 229 to be two grade levels above their average. So I'm going to guess that their average had to be about 259 or 260, which is very good. Science was above. Reading, we were still going to get rid of the music testing. It was good with math testing, but the ESUs are trying to get that accomplished. One less test they have to take. So as soon as they're done, I'll compile that information like I did last year to the teachers, the ones that will be borderline, won't pass the test, that kind of thing. And we'll have to start doing some interventions and things with them after school like we did last year. And then the majority of those kids ended up coming through at the end. They just did some intensive things before we started state testing. So, and speaking of state testing, it's all sitting in the back room. I haven't even opened it yet. We don't test until about the third week of April, because we have FCCLA has their state convention, FFA has their state convention. Track meets, golf, you name it, it goes on. So you have to try to work around all of those things. Parent-teacher conferences, we had an 84% turnout rate over the entire school. I think our numbers were pretty good. When I go to my meeting, I went to my meeting last month, and most of these schools can only get 50% of people to show up. So when I went to National Principals Convention, there was a school by Lincoln that 37% turnout rate. So they just have kind of flipped the thing now, so I have how he does that, which is kind of an interesting concept. I started preliminary scheduling and looking for conflicts, and so now it's the numbers game, trying to figure out where these conflicts will be and move things around. External visit will take place on April 6th. The committee will arrive about 8 o'clock.
I've met with Mrs. Mosel and I'm going to have student council be a part of that, greeting at the door. One thing I have them do is take them around when they tour the building and visit classrooms, because on the ones that I've been on, like the Bloomfield one and Open Valley, Neely, those buildings have been added on so many times that I had no idea where I ended up. Most of the time I was on the other side of the building where I needed to be. So our student council's going to help with that a little bit. And some of you, I will be asking you to come in and meet with them as well. So I need a couple people to come in and visit. Title I plan has to be submitted by April 1st for peer review. We are not self-review. We have to submit it to the state. They submit it to a group of Title I teachers that will meet with work and they will tell us what we need to fix and not fix. So we did it. Good job that last time, so I'm not really too concerned. The summer reading program, correct, summer reading? Yes. Summer reading is going to be taught by Ms. Wobbs and Ms. Schnell, different from our summer
school.
This year, Mrs. Darnell has decided to be involved and she wants to incorporate some elementary Spanish. So I think they're going to start being for this year and then figure out how to make that work. So. A few elementary classes have taken their field trips and the rest of them will all be going here within the next month or so. Minus the sixth graders who usually go in May. Prom is April 9th. Did you get your invitation? It will be at the Legion. I have talked to Green and they made a visit down there last Thursday to get them all set up. Everything's going to be down there. Most prom's going to be here. Coming? Alumni is April 2nd. Shirley does a really good job of that and she pretty much sets all of that up. FFA attended the CDA contest. All I was basically given is they did very well and some of them were going to state. In the paper, so he gave the specifics to the paper, but it wasn't good news. State FFA, FCCLA is coming up. Jump Rope for Heart is March 15th, tomorrow. District speech is Wednesday. We've had lots of quiz bowls. Our kids participated in the one on the radio and did very well. We sent several students to ESU, both junior high and high school. I think both of them ended up around 7th place, Mr. Klein said. Miles of Smiles for the elementary is March 29th. Northeast Academic Contest is March 30th. And we have a lot of things going on between now and then. Lots of music, lots of track, lots of everything. The calendar's full pretty much every single day. And I also want to thank you for the opportunity to go to National Convention.
So once the kids get to go on the field trip this year?
There's a couple that have to earn it back already.
Okay, thank you. President's report, again, I'd like to thank the board for all the hard work this month with all the extra meetings that we had. And I thought it went very well. I'm real happy with the results. I think we hired a good superintendent.
Superintendent's report.
Of the fact that they might be right.
So I guess my suggestion on that, if you've got some ideas, is some people think would be good board members, maybe coerce them a little bit. See if you can do that. Not as we support them at point or something.
So can we start getting like insurance or something as an incentive?
How many member board do you want?
Ability Grant. I've actually got that approved this week. You know, it always works this way. I've been doing these grants on the grants management system for 15 years now. This is the first one that's gone through without a hitch. Someplace. Always get them back and have to do them over. This one went through, so.
You must have learned something.
I don't think that would be the problem. This one was a little bit easier. And I don't know if I talked about this last month or not, but despite my stroke of luck, I even started the process of applying for it, because I usually wait a little bit longer. I had brought copies of the grant out, started looking at it, and made a phone call, found out right before they went to Chicago. We wanted to use the money for that. We had to have it approved before they went. So I called down to Diane Schemer down at the State Department. She approved it by email, I think on that Thursday, and they left Tuesday, whatever it was. So otherwise, I would normally wait until after that. I would have found another way, you know, to spend the money. Originally, when we did our NCLB application, we had to set aside just a little over $6,000 to spend on staff development, which we plan on spending on this conference. But we get back a little over $4,000 for this. It worked out pretty well. The air conditioning unit, I don't know how many months we talked about this. I think they finished installing it today, so it looked up. So it is, they put it up. Friday they came, they got put up Saturday, and they come back today, and I think they're here with water. So that's done.
Cranny the horn side. Hold it up. I was walking, I would have been interested to see that thing.
Affordable Health Care Act. Pass this around. Talked a little bit about this last month. I met with, Ryan Eugene and I met with the kitchen staff and with the paraprofessionals last week. It was on Wednesday. And I kind of basically used this as a guideline to go through with them. After recording hours worked by all of our staff members and that, they're pretty confident in saying we're going to be in the middle group of 50 to 99 FTEs, which means we need to begin providing affordable health care by January 1, which is just passed, but because our insurance doesn't start until September 1, we have until September 1 to do that. So, trying to explain in here for the staff members a little bit of how all this works, but basically, the FTEs, I figured we have about 70 staff members, but they're not full time. And when you take summer people that work, like take the paras for example, don't work during the summer, so they're not a full time FTE. That's why we had to record their hours. A couple of those positions get very close to FTEs. My suggestion to the board, let me back up a little bit. Affordable Health Care Act says that if an employee works full time, one FTE, you have to offer them affordable health care. So to avoid getting in a situation where maybe somebody, one month Imogene, they get enough hours, they could kind of creep into that category, even if they don't every month. To ensure that we don't get in a situation where the school district could be penalized, I'm kind of going off the idea that maybe for the kitchen staff and the paraprofessionals, we offer it to all. That would have to know, but I think might takes that gray area out of there of maybe somebody slipping in.
All right, yeah, just half time that they're a long ways through.
Well, none of the kitchen staff and the paras are half time. Now, we get into our bus drivers and that, we always log that. If they're far enough down, I don't think there's any chance they're going to. We even have to log substitute teachers. So we try to be careful not having somebody come like more than 3 days a week. Now, we could have
unless
situations.
It's Jasmine. I can abuse him all I want.
And we are going to have, if you get a long term long-term sub or something that could affect that, so it all kind of plays into this, makes it a little bit difficult to manage it, so. In order to be affordable, whatever you offer them, the employee cannot be required to pay more than 9.5% of their income. Now, that is their staff or their family income. I kind of took the position, we don't know what the family income is. I took it on probably the lowest paid staff be in that area. And if I do that, I need to look at a $1,500 or $4,000 deductible. Figured out the percentages for the either employee share or what the district would have to pay to make sure that we would meet that amount. So I would suggest maybe if you look kind of this sheet over, if you have questions, you know, stop, take some time to talk to me about it. Within the next month or two, at least before I leave, I would like to probably have the board make a decision what you're going to offer. Like I said, I gave this information to the staff members to get them thinking about it. And we will come back to them in the next month or two and probably ask them, are you interested in insurance or not? Now, they do not have to take it. We have to offer it to them. They do not have to take it. But if they don't, if we offer it, they don't take it, then they need to sign off on it.
We don't have to give them in lieu of.
No, we do not have to give them anything in lieu of.
Do we have, is there a family plan that's going along with that?
This is it. Affordable health care says you only have to offer single insurance.
I know, but can we offer
a family plan? You could offer a family plan, but
most of them would not probably make enough to pay the additional premium.
Unless the board is willing to pick up the entire amount, but now you're looking at big bucks.
You don't have to raise them.
And you're looking at family insurance and teachers are on, what, about 18,000? Year now, a little over the 18,000.
1,500.
It's pretty expensive.
Are you still looking like at 12 people? At one time you mentioned you thought that was anywhere.
I'm guessing we're going to be someplace in there, Jason. I don't know. Do we ask him for sure? And I also told the staff members to ask around, ask some questions, because the attorneys we've talked to suggested that you be fairly cautious because there are situations where people have turned down insurance or decided to take what a company offers and then finds out it hurts them in the long run. So I hope they'll do some research on it to get what's best for them.
Can they start and stop on their own anytime?
I think only at the beginning of the year they can go on, I believe. At the beginning of the summer.
I mean,
there'll be
stop
an open.
I don't believe so. I think they have to stay in there for the year. I don't know that for sure. There'll be an open enrollment period, and then we'll have to use that period to enroll, and they won't be able to pick it up later.
Are they 12 months?
I mean, if it's worth that.
They only get paid during the school year.
They only get paid 9 months,
I mean,
so it'll be divided between their share of the
If they still work,
so their insurance
will go
off.
They have insurance.
No, they'll have insurance. Okay. But they're
so
going to have to pay their share of a year.
We did also talk about the situation, they're working 10 months, and that premium is for 12, we will prorate that amount so it's paid for the time you're taking out their salary.
So that they don't have to worry about
it. So they don't have to make payments during the summer.
We really don't want them to have to pay us.
Some people might be in a situation where if they got full family and they need to pay, it would be worth it.
When I started at Scribner Schneider, one of our kitchen staff members, because they offered insurance at that time, they made more money on insurance than they did just there. So they worked half time. They worked 11 hours half time. And their insurance was more than what they were taking. But the board ended up making the decision that probably wasn't the best interest to do, and that's the way they're taking insurance away.
Minimum wage going to affect you again?
We were not affected by the minimum wage.
Schools are not affected by the state minimum wage, the federal change. Is that right?
Yeah,
or
I think so. That's right. Probably next month, I'll have more agenda for the
class.
Yeah.
We're all over
that.
The class.
classified staff at every 3 months.
So this deductible $15,000 or $4,000, will that be their option or that we have to pick one of those that we're gonna offer?
The board will probably have to decide which
one or the other.
I took these because they're on the Blue Cross Blue Shield thing that we get. As plans that they have available. I use that just to kind of show you how the percentages will work out. The thing there, when you look at the employee share, we've got to keep that number between underneath that $1,187.50, which is 9.5% of the lowest paid person's salary. We'll be talking about it this morning. Yeah. But if you look at this, you have questions, please come in and visit with me about it. I'll try to confuse you more or unconfuse you.
Okay, thank you. Looks like we're ready to go into closed session.
Motion to enter a closed session for the purpose of discussing principal salary negotiations.
Do you have a second?
I'll second.
Okay. Steve?
Yes.
Vicki?
Yes.
Myself, yes. Mike?
Yes.
Mike?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay, we're going into executive session.
That clock, it is 7:03. It's 7:03. It's like 7:03.
I got about 7.
It's catching up though, I've been watching.
Yeah, it's finally starting.
It's going around, huh?
March, okay.
Yes, and I have 7:03.